everybody. This is John Bain. I want to welcome you to Scrap Mechanics Survival.
Hopefully you guys are doing pretty good today. I'm doing good myself.
Don't want to forget to remind you all to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you can be here when the stuff happens. Because, well, there we go. We're back with some more Scrap Mechanics Survival. Anyway, we're here. And I've been super busy trying to get some more stuff done.
I did a lot of underwater activities, actually, since the last episode. I got about 100 glue clams. And, oh yeah, I gotta turn that back on. And I got more than this. I've crafted a couple things with it, but I got that much of those, and I got about 200 oil. The reason why I got 200 oil is to prepare us for today's episode, which is so we can go explore without thinking about anything. It really wasn't that bad. Oh, there's an upgrade. Let me show you this. Okay, watch this. Bam. I know it's not much, but still, it's cool. So now I can adjust the... I turn the engine off because it seems like it does use gas whenever it's... if it's left on at all so far, it seems like that. I don't know. But yeah, I paid for a controller and I'm fighting some farm bots because I did some farming too and a bunch of other things. But it's pretty cool. It's nice. Oh, also, I widened the front end and the back end by one block on each side to kind of give it a little bit more stability. Center of gravity set up a little bit better. So, and I tested it and it seems it works pretty good. The only thing we're lacking is the power in our suspension. So luckily, while I was doing farming, I fought some farm bots and also did some farming. And some hay bots came by and I was able to get some more of the lovely, yes, these. And I'm hitting that door. The doors make it sound. So let me go ahead and grab this out of our storage area. And pop you right into here. And let's go ahead and see how these how the single upgrade does. Please do good. Please do good. Upgrade one. Upgrade one. It's probably not going to be enough. It was just enough before, but I fortified the armor a little bit more. All right, and then we'll... Oh, it will be enough. Holy crap. Okay, so we might not need... I might need to lower it some so I can get a nice, like, somewhat compressed... I want the back end to have actually probably full limit. Okay, oh, we gotta open that up so I can start up the engine. Engine, we're gonna go to right there. Close that down. Oh, it's already handling better. Oh yeah, that's handling way better. And it could take probably could take a corner pretty decent too. Let's find out. Up. Oh. Still a little bit there. I was going a little fast. I should really slow down when I do that. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and lower a little bit in the front. I probably really could stand to go one more wider, but I kind of want to not go too wide because of trees and stuff. Just kind of let the front end kind of compress a little bit so when the momentum of it kind of pushes forward. It does travel pretty dang good, though. And so the back end's kind of like struts. The front end's like straight up. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, whoa. That was kind of crazy. Still some of the good oldness in there. Yeah, and the grip on this is amazing. Oh, yeah. Oops, I kind of turned a little bit first, but we're not really... Yeah, this is much better. So I think this will accomplish our needs. Oh, I forgot to say. Thank you guys so much for the support of the videos, too. I really do appreciate it. I do read the comments, and I appreciate the likes and you guys that are sharing it and coming back and hanging out. Thank you very much. It makes my day, and thank you. I just wanted to make sure I say thank you to you guys because it is appreciated. All right, welcome back, and we got to get ready to go. I actually have been just trying to get stuff together for our trip. Actually, I'm going to put these away in here. Let's arrange them a little bit nicer like that. I'm going to keep that on me. I'm going to keep these couple guys. Actually, put them there. This on me, just in case, need to do some on-the-spot repairs. I do want to say, like, the series so far, just in case you guys are wondering, the mentality behind it has been to figure out the basics of the game, of what they want you to do, and then see if we can get the next level on stuff to, get it to where... Let's try it with one more down. Next level to where, you know, we like with the mining and stuff, like the metal is something that we will need a lot of for a long time, and getting stone for base building. So that's why we pushed for the drill first and then got into the refinery and the resource collector. With the resource collector and refinery, though, we can do our we can actually process wood. I didn't go into the saws yet because we needed some other mats too, I felt. And okay, we've already been over here. Other mats and stuff like that. And then I was like, well, now we need components really bad. And so I've just been trying to, that's what we're doing right now is, well, we need to explore to see what else there's on the map, but also to get more components so we know what's going on. Is the seat still here or is it gone? It's here. Okay, we got a seat now. This is a, thanks, Scrapman. So yeah, that's what this whole thing is. Like we've been to a couple spots already. Actually, we need your circuitry too, man. Come here. Easy peasy. There's lights and stuff here, but we're not out for that. There's like two or three of these pretty close by. It looks like they respawn. We have a little chat. Scrapman was saying that he thought they respawned too while we were checking out the honeycomb stuff. And that's one thing I probably should do is look for a honeycomb a little bit. But let's go down to where we've been already because we've been down here at the packing station and seeing what's over here. Let's just go down the road some and just see what there is. We haven't really explored much other than, you know, where we're at, and all the maps between all the different people you see playing are different. In case you guys didn't know, they're different. My map is different than everyone else's map and all the way around. There might be some things that look kind of similar, like POIs and stuff, but generally speaking, you know, they're all different. Oh, it's only supposed to go in 30 fast. That's it. Oh, look at the tree just say this is my road. Is there anything with it? We're checking POIs, might as well check it. No, I'm not seeing anything. There's another ember forest over there too. Nice. Okay, that's good. Just follow the road up the broken road and then look to the right and there's some more ember. Nice. Alright, this thing goes up that way. There's a POI back. There's two POIs back there, okay. There's another one of these curvy, messed up tree areas. I probably won't be able to get through this without hitting something. Oh, yeah, we hit it all. Okay, great. Okay, is there anything up here? Oh, I should say, what's up here? Oh, there's a, okay, there's that. There's a overhang portion here with the moo, oh look, is that moo cow stuff going everywhere or is it just water? Oh, that's cool, I hadn't seen something like that now. It sprung a leak! Can we get water from that? I wonder if we had a bucket, if it would let us capture that. I doubt it, but that'd be kind of cool if that was a thing. Or like if we had a water container. That ember forest is huge. Okay, some more POIs. I'm gonna stop. After we go down this road to see where it leads to for a while, then we'll stop and check. What is this? Is this another packing station? It is. So we have two packing stations. Okay. Neat. There's the big place that we're not the place. Oh crap! It's sorry. That's not a safe place to put one of these, just in case you're wondering. Oh, we'll take it. That's what we need. Well, thank you. Okay, you just want to make sure we got that. Thank you. I appreciate it. Whoever I'm talking to. Don't see anything there. Let's head on down this way, shall we? And we're making pretty good distance, actually. Just trying to make sure I don't miss anything. Is this another water spot? It is. Oh, really? And it's near another huge one of those. And there's a packing station around the corner. There's some beeswax over there. I'm going to grab that real quick. A little pull off here. And this is a little area, too. I like that. Potential base areas? Maybe. Give me your beeswax. Is that it? Is that all of it? Looks like it is. Huh. Potential base area stuff. There's a little... Oh, I hear a guy. Oh, this is the Haybot, right? Thought I heard him. It's not near the vehicle. There it is. I gotta kill you. I hope you might drop components. There we go. And he did not, but we can still take this. And I'm not gonna save the logs... like to bring back and process. I'm just gonna process them on site because there's no reason to do that. That's why I didn't make a resource collector or anything on this vehicle. It needs to be like closer. I wouldn't call it really lightweight, but a less overhead. So it's great for like carrying individual stacked products, not the actual logs and stuff. And that's what the point of this was to kind of also keep me from getting kind of crazy with collecting, because then I'll find a spot of like, oh, I could get a bunch of this even though I don't need it right now type of thing going on. And well, now I can't really do that. There's another one of those broke. Okay, so these are consistent POIs. points of interest. I know a lot of people, I don't know why people don't care for that statement, but that's what they're known in a lot of games, you know. What's up over here? That's different looking. And this leads to the warehouse, huh? There's another guy there. Just skedaddle on by. Okay, I've been to one of those before. And this is another one of those facing. I like how they did, how they reused their assets and made things work. This leads straight into it. Okay. And that's what we have here. Okay, I'm going to do this. I'm going to go ahead and head back. There's some beehives over there, too. I'm going to grab that. This is a no... Actually, let's do this real quick. Let's use it. There, I'm now respawn on it. Let's take just a quick gander. I know I'm not supposed to go in there. I'm not going to... Oh, there's the hitbot. I'm glad I did this. Come here. Where are you going? Hey. Oh, you're going out there. Are you going out to the moonwalk? Why are you going out to the moonwalk? Because they're nice things. There we go. And where is your limb? Give me your limbs. There it is. Hey, Mr. Moonwalk, we're just trying to help you out here. Don't mind us. No, we're not cannibals because we're not robots, so we're not actually going to eat ourselves. You know what I'm saying? All right, let's go. Right here. Okay, cool. I'm going to eat a... Try one of these juicy burger things. Pizza burgers. It was okay. I'm going to grab me some tomatoes then. I thought that would help out a lot more than it did. Wrong thing. Up in the front, I did. Let's grab a stack of tomatoes, too. That sounds like a winner to me. There we go. Out adventuring, you know, just can't be, like, getting all thirsty. All right, that works for me. Let's just take a gander. I wish we had, like, a telescope or something. Hello? Come on. You can get closer. There you go. It's almost like the turtles in Ark. Just stay right out of the range, and you're good to go. What's that over there? Is that more of this? It is. Okay. This looks like this is a huge, huge area then. Interesting. Dun 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 dun. Are any of these things like disassemblable? They are? Really? It had a controller. Oh, we got controllers. I'm taking this stuff, man. I am not too good for that. I will accept your offerings. Can I grab this too? Oh, those are little pieces like that. What is that then? It doesn't matter. It's mine. How about that? It's a bearing. Okay. Oh, yeah, baby. Yeah, more blocks that I've never seen before. Wait. So are you're part of the, okay, you're part of the environment. I can't take you apart, but I can take all this stuff, man. Okay, I'm glad we got up a little bit closer because this is freebie stuff I will take all day long. Inventory full. Oh, there's single block stuff. What is this called? Road sign base, metallic tube straight. What? How strong is that? 4 durability. This actually has a good amount of durability. That has 5 durability. Fan cap blade. There's a small pipe bin. I don't necessarily need that. What is this? A ship compartment. What? How much space do you got in here? None. Okay. That is correct. It is nope. Okay. So let's do this. I'm going to put that back. I do want to watch out. There might be baddies in here other than myself. All right. We're going to grab that controller. Is there... What is this? Oh, man. There's something else there. Oh, the controllers don't stack either. Generator pipe holder. I'm just going to go ahead and drop all the stuff because I don't necessarily need it right now. And this is what I was afraid of. I know I got spaces on. What am I doing? We got spaces on our car we can grab. We can fill it up. If I don't need it, then I'll drop it somewhere else. How about that? All right, I'm going to disassemble this. If I find anything really cool, I'll be back. I'm not really going to go in there because I feel like that's bad. And, yeah, we got other things to go explore anyway within the time we got in the episode. So you guys, hold on. All right, I could have helped myself. I got it. I came back in here. These pallets are, like, 5 durability and would make great base walls. You know what I mean? Like that would be top-notch. That's the thing. And you can take these pipes, and I don't think you can take these. Oh, you can. What are you? You rusted metal, too? Rusted metal block. Yeah, that's... Okay, so these are just musted rattle blocks. Really? Is that what you're going to say, John? Is that what you were going to say? But I haven't seen anything else yet, and I've been trying to keep a, you know, have my eye on the horizons here for anything moving that might shoot at me. Okay, if there's any like that right there. There's something right there. There's something right there. I don't care. I'm not gonna fight it. I'm just gonna run. If this is an area we're not supposed to be in, I wouldn't be surprised if things are bad. Ooh, can I get those? No, I can't. Is this area clear? No, there's one right there. Isn't that one? Yes, it is. All right. And I'm wondering what these are. Like, because I picked one up. I don't know. Oh, I can look at it from here. Stone crate. Are these the crates that we can sell? I'm just going to grab it and see, man. I mean, why not, right? Yeah, we got some of those. I don't know how good that is. Okay, cool. I just wanted to show you the inside as much as I was willing to do, and that's as much as I was willing to do. I did grab the other controller here, and there was a cool seat inside that I grabbed too, but anyway, okay, I'm going to head back some. I'm going to go ahead and hit up some of these other guys on the way back, and y'all hold on. Welcome back, and it's been about an hour, to be honest. Hey, what is that just hanging out here? It's been about an hour. We've been really, really busy. Oh, we've been getting a lot of stuff, too. And I'm going to save this Moo Walk. Come here, Moo Walk. Not you. It's Greeny, not the Moo Walk. Moo Walk, you can run away. You're fine. It's safe. We got your back. Anyway, we've actually turned out to get a good amount of stuff, honestly. Like, look, food-wise, I mean, soil 16. We got 34 lovely, 34 fertilizer, 8 cans of the great tasty Moo Milk stuff. Some seeds. We actually got banana seeds. We got 2 of those, so we'll be able to start growing banana plants soon and test those out. I'm looking forward to that. Actually, here's some potatoes. We have 2 new outfit thingies. Look at all the components we've got. Was that 68 components? That is... Guys, we're going to have some fun. That's all I got to say right now. We're going to have some fun. And another thing, too, is I'm coming out on the positive side of the gas. I'm looting so much of it that it's... I hear the big guy. Oh, there's a head right there. I will grab that. There he is back there. Holy crap. Wow. All right, we're not going to go that way. We're going to go through the woods. Over the river and through the woods. And we still have a little bit more to, exploring to do. I'm glad I went through all the POIs on the way back. Again, there's nothing really different happening. I mean, I'm more efficient in clearing them out now. I haven't died at all. That's 0 deaths. But, you know, generally speaking, we've done really good with our runs here. And another thing I was thinking about with our setup is that, you know, if we want to, we could just, like, pick it up and then bring these in and then replace them with other ones, you know, to make the making like transferring them out really easy. You know what I mean? Like, so if you were working with a group of people and there's people up back at the base, managing the base, doing base stuff while the people are exploring, and you had a setup like this, you could just have the guy at the base could have 6 empty ones waiting. They pull up, you could fill up the gas, switch out like the 6 of them and then move on. And you can make the most of the efficiency, which I think would be this really cool idea. So, that's nifty, but since we don't have anyone like that, I'm just gonna, you know, do this and this and all this stuff. I am going to leave in the carrots and we'll put all this inside. And let me get unloaded here. Well, let me show you everything first. So we have, this was our food situation. Then, as you guys saw, we have a lot of components, some more circuit. Ooh, those weren't arranged correctly. Okay, more circuits. I got a decent amount of scrap metal, which is great. Batteries, chemicals, glass. We got some more honeycomb too, or a beeswax, whatever. And then we're already getting in the plus of the gas that we started with, which is a nice situation to be in. Here we actually got some cool components. 2 controllers, we got a suspension, 2 different seats, 7 bearings, a switch, and then there's this awesome. It's gonna be like a control headquarters when we make one. And I bet you anything we could do this. Nice. That's awesome. So we got one of those too, which is really cool. And then this is the these guys here. again, they'll make a great, great defensive wall system because, like, the ones back here, I've been layering these, and those are the most powerful quick finds we had. They have three durability. I'm not saying what we're getting is impervious, but the stronger something is, the better. And these guys here have five. So that was a good win. That's a good win right there. We got another head we got to put on the wall. So we have two more heads now, I think. I don't know, man. It's been a crazy long. This episode has taken a while to do. I'm not complaining. That's just how it is right now. So anyway, I'm gonna get things unloaded, and we're gonna go down the other road we've got near us and head in that direction to see what the deal is. So you guys, hold on. All right, we're on our way. I've unloaded. I've gotten some more supplies for food, whatnot, just in case. And we're going to head on this way and see what else is up here. Now, we encountered a boss up here the first time with our first vehicle. So we just got to be a little bit aware. Actually, why am I even going along the road when I can just cut across it here? Just have to be aware of the situation at hand. So we're going to try and stay aware whilst looking for interesting things to see. Because we're gonna skip the regular points of interest, and I'll farm those on the way back. There's the boss back there. Good thing we saw it. Moving along, not stopping. Looks like it goes down in a dip over there. Oh, there's another one of these. So we've got more than one of those guys. Okay. Not seeing anything too interesting there. Hello there, Moomok. Moomok. Wow. Moomok. Moomok. I am Moomok, king of the wicker people. There's another one of these places here. Hopefully this doesn't dead end here, because that would kind of suck. It looks like it might. It does. There's another one of those big trees. What are those? Is that just a sign? Oh, that's just like a turning sign. Can we take those? Oh, we can. Neat. Okay, how good are you? Oh, heck yeah, we're taking them. They're worth that much? Yeah, they'll do just fine. They'll do just fine. Perfect. And they'll be great decorative too. And it's just not this side. We've been putting them on this side on the front. And I know it's sliding. I know it's sliding, guys. Just calm down. Earth is fine. So I need to pay attention for those whenever we're driving, because that's a decent, you know, little wall thing. There's another boss. Okay. Well then. We need to find more areas. I feel like we're missing stuff here. Kind of hesitant on driving off-road. That's the kind of, like, I was hoping that this would actually lead us to some interesting stuff. I guess we should just go ahead and commit, since we can use that as a point of reference. We can kind of go around it and see if there's anything behind it. Maybe another road. Maybe death. Maybe a bunch of water that we can't get across normally. You know, with all this water, we really need to go ahead and make a raft soon. That might end up being... There's a couple things I want to do first, but very, very, very soon we're going to be doing a raft. Raft! There's that way around the back. Let's try that out. See that? It looks like there's a road on the other side, too. Okay. We can go around then. You could probably go through if I felt comfortable enough, but I'd rather have some weaponry and stuff like that installed on the vehicle before I go through a highly, you know, secured area. I just feel like that's a smart thing to do. All right, there we go. All right, okay, cool. So now we can continue on with our explorations, shall we? And nothing yet. Just another one of the tree things. I'm glad we've got some time, too, for daytime, so that's good. I'm glad we got all that gas, too. That really makes me feel good. Like, having farmed all that, that means we have a nice, again, a buffer between, like, you know, our needs and what you know, like, how much excess we've got. That looks like a different top on it, but it looks like about the same POI. Keep on going. There's a dead tree over there. Oh, this is an intersection. A weird intersection at that. Okay. I feel like we should just continue this way.
if there's anything special over on this end. There's another one of the places that are springing water out. It'd be crazy if they made the map a loop, you know? And it goes this way. Kind of a little swoop-de-doo going on here. Swoop-de-doo! Sorry, I'm concentrating. Well, hello. Goodbye. I was concentrating pretty good here just to see, make sure if anything popped out, we wouldn't miss it. Nothing new here. I do like how all the water is, though. So this goes out a little peninsula or something. Whoa, first flip in a while, actually. I've been actually doing really good with this setup. Okay, there's more of that. It's funny, the further I go out, the more I'm going to have to scavenge on the way back. Hopefully I've got enough room in my boxes. This is interesting. Alright, well, I'm going to continue on until I find something different, guys. I don't want to spend the whole time, you know, just driving. You know, we kind of have to, yeah, kind of need some things happening. And, well, we're just kind of just driving right now. So we'll be right back. Alright, I got to the end of the road. There's a dead end over there, and there's this over here. And it looks like it has two passages or whatever, paths leading out. Like, you're going to go hiking out here or something. I wonder what the deal is here. Yeah, it's interesting. It's like here's the end of the road. Park, come up this way now. Hopefully it's not like to our deaths. That would suck. I mean, we're bound to our vehicle, so it's okay. But let's see what the deal. What's going on here? What's going on, buddy? Oh, it's a smart. What? It's Nicholas's cages. Oh my God! There's a ton of them. Oh my God, there is a ton of them. Holy crap. Are you his cousin? Wow. Okay. It's like a bad beat going on with them, huh? And there's nothing in these tents, are there? There was, I think some people said that they thought they saw a key in the one of the previous episodes, and there was only junk inside of them. There was no keys. I tried to interact with everything when I tried to search before, and it's like definitely not a thing. I know these guys are supposed to go somewhere. Now Nicholas Cage back at our base is he's a permanent resident. Like when we move, he's moving with us. You know what I'm saying? But like these fellas here, I mean, yeah, there's nothing going on. Oh, that is weird. Okay, so there's a crap load right there spawned. And there's nothing else here. I do like how this area looks, though. It's nice. You know what would be really cool? It's like farm-bought sharks. If they had those in the water, you know? And you kill them, you get, like, oil or something with them. Something like that. That'd be kind of nifty. All right, so does this side, is this the side that circles back around? That was crazy, man. I can't do anything about it right now. That'd be something to have a vehicle made to move them, you know, like specific like roles. That's one thing too, is like for me, for vehicle wise, I'm going to have specific roles anyway. You know, like the mining one, I'd like to have some sort of attachment on the back for potential refinery to hook to the mining guy. And then maybe the buzz chomper we're going to make or something like that. Just stuff like that. I think specific roles and stuff like that. I guess we need to make one to roll those guys and actually pick them up or move them. Huh, interestingness. Interestingness. Okay, I'm going to head back to that intersection that we were at a while ago and come back and see what's down that way, because we got some more exploring to do. You guys, hold on. So, I continued driving down the way that I came, that we remember the split was, and we said, I will go by and come back this way, and I'm going this way, and I found another scrap place. I wonder if it's the same big map for everyone, we just have different starting locations that randomize. Because that's pretty crazy. Excuse me, little guy. Granny. Oops. Oh, my bad. Oh, let's grab that circuit. Oh, does it end over there? Is that the end of it? This is kind of weird. I haven't really come across anything else other than like standard issue stuff so far. Yeah, that's the end of it. And it doesn't continue on the other side. Holy crap.
some beeswax. I was just hoping actually to find somebody that we could trade crates with. Huh. Okay. This has been about 2 hours so far, guys. Grant, there's that thing over there. I've seen several of those now. About 2 hours of we did a lot of like work too, but like, you know, like clearing out places and getting loot, but still, it's just like crazy, man. Like we've done a lot. We've covered a lot of ground. That's what I'm trying to say. We've covered a lot of ground. I don't know. I'm getting like kind of like brainy, like, you know, just trying to, you know, figure out, okay, is there any other ways? There's nothing off main roads left to go. Huh. Well then, I wonder, we gotta look around some. I just think this is kind of crazy, man. There's two of these. I figured there'd only be one on the map, but I guess that's just me assuming things. So that's two of these guys we have confirmed being on the map. Is that something there glowing? Yes, it is. We can't leave that behind. I got a trained eye for it now. I gotta kill the greenie. Considering we ran over his friend, we might as well go ahead and get rid of him too. But yeah, so this has been an interesting experience so far. Like just exploring some, getting to know the map more, has I wouldn't say challenge or anything. Just, you know, I don't want to go too far because we're already so far off the map. I mean, away from our starting area, that I feel like we would be. You know what? I bet you that is the one that looks like. That's assumptions on my end again. I was gonna say, it looks like the first one we went to and got all the stuff from already. And there is a large area here for, wow. Huh. Well, let me see if I can find any more roads. This looks like it might be a little bit of a longer episode again because we're trying to find something and find stuff and I just wanted to explore the map. And well, that's definitely what we're doing, but give me a little bit. We'll be right back. Okay, I decided to come over to this thing and this is definitely different. It looks like there's like pink water. Okay. It's been about another hour, by the way. And I meant to show you guys something. I figured something out. So if you're going to go off the road, have a lot of bearings. They're super cheap, like 5 scrap metal. Okay. 5 scrap metal. You take this and take this. And if you have a stack of something, do this and then pop one on there. And then you'll have a marker that you can see in the distance to know which way to go back to. You see how you can still see it? You could use probably something that's a different color, maybe even a switch or something. So it's like a bright green, but it's still blue. So if you know the general direction and then you need something to see, you can still see it pretty much. If you look real carefully, it's still there. It's still there. It's starting to fade out now. It's still there though. So I was thinking that would be a great like beacon system. All you know, because headlights are kind of expensive, you could use a lamp maybe put on top, but they don't stack. But these guys do. I wonder if you put one on either side, if it would make it more visible too. So if you're worried about seeing it, it depends on what direction you're coming from. So you could do it. Let's try this out then. Like that. And then you have a double blue right there. Oh, yeah. I mean, granted, you can see it here, but if you're in, like, a forest or something like that, you can still see it now. So there's some that's something there. That might work out in the end. That might be something to use in the future, especially if you're on foot and just trying to get through somewhere. But I just figured I'd share that real quick because I was thinking about that while I was, just get rid of the blocks. Grinding, getting some more mat. Hitting the POIs. Let's put this back in there. Well, let's see what's in this place, man. I got you on a lift? Yes. All right, let's see what the deal is. What is this? This is bad for me? Oh, yes, it is. It's bad for you. Okay. Don't go in that. Is that the this is the stuff we need to make. To make chemicals. This, if you look at the inside the craft bot, there's a chemical recipe. You need these. This water, it had a darker color water for it. And I was wondering what that was, and this is what it was! Okay, we're gonna be careful. It's night now, but we're still gonna be careful. All right, we just made it home. This has been a very long, long day, episode, whatever you want to call it, of doing stuff, and we made it back. I got stuff on there. I got stuff on me. One thing I want to do before we end the episode, though, other than tell you guys thank you so much for hanging out. I really appreciate it, but I'm going to upgrade this guy. We're going to upgrade him once, and then we can upgrade him with 20. We're going to do it, because I want to see. I was thinking about this. Do we get anything else? Nothing. Level 5 craft bot. Is there anything good by doing level 5? I see no more parts, no more blocks, no more tools, nothing. Maybe he does it faster now? Let's see. Let me make one of these. It is faster. Okay, so the last upgrade is fast. Okay. Well, that's actually really nice then. What's that? Oh, you can make it do repeating. Oh, okay. Well, that was really cool to find out. All right, welcome back. I got a wild hair up my butt, decided to do some random looking around where the packing facility was. So I went up here, did a hard left. Next, by the way, I got rid of the rear steering, so we don't have four-wheel turning. We only have two-wheel steering, whatever. It does okay. I did turn up the power a little bit, but it does pretty all right. Both have their drawbacks, both have their bonuses. Anyway, went this way, and it figures. Look. You gonna stay still? No? All right, let's put you over here. So, it says, keep out. Keep out bots. No, can I pick up these? No. I can break them, though. Oopsie. Sorry, sign. Didn't mean to do that. Keep out. Keep out. I wish I could grab these. Can I grab on this? No. So, somewhere in here is a place. Okay. I see a windmill. Hell, this is actually pretty nice. Can I build in here? I could build a base in here. That'd be interesting. Like, it's actually pretty nice. It's got water and everything. Maybe we could take this thing over. Okay, there's a windmill. Okay, so. What do they want? They want Nicolas Cage or supplies. Wait a minute. I want to see the things we got from the place. Will it take the place of things that we brought? That we grabbed from the warehouse? It's not vegetables, but there's still crates of stuff. I wonder if I need to just break the crates down and I get mats or something. I don't know. Let's go over here. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Come on. All right, we're going to drive in here, even if it says keep out. Well, we can probably slide in here. Let's be real careful. Be real careful. There we go. All right, so let's see what the deal is here. We have the guy, the thing that sucks things up right here. Okay, cool. All right, I don't think this will work, but it's just interesting to find out. For science, you know what I'm saying? Let's grab you, put you there. Let's press 6. Does that count? Will you take that? Probably not, no. Can I break you then? Oh, okay. Well, then there we go. We know what the deal is. All right, so it takes the packaged vegetables and stuff that we can do at the packing place just around the corner. Okay. Well, I should have... You figures, you know, you'd follow the road or something like that, but nope, had to do a wild turn and find the place. This actually looks really cool. Can we... Well, oh, there he is! What's up, dude? How'd you get yours? You're at my base. So, they will trade 1 carat per. Oh, and this, you load it up with this. It gives the currency. Ah, there we go. They want blueberries and bananas. Is that, that's oranges, blueberries, and dudes. Okay, and then this is like broccoli. That's pineapples. And then those are just dudes and broccoli and pineapples. So, it's only 5 tomatoes for a saw blade. Are you serious? Or is it 5 crates? So that's 50 of them. So it takes 50 tomatoes for that. I still would rather grind my own mats than and pay for that. But we can get the banana seeds from them, orange seeds, blueberry seeds. So I got banana seeds already, and I believe I got orange ones, but I don't have that one. I'm surprised they don't have broccoli seeds for sale. Or pineapple. I guess that's something we just got to get lucky to find. Does he let them out or something? Oh, here we go, right here. Oh, okay. Thanks. Appreciate that. Anything else? Anything else you want to let me grab? That's funny. What's it look like inside there? He's got a little wood stump. There's a door thing. Is there anything around the back? Dang, this is a big place. Why doesn't he get rid of by farm bots? Do I need to get signs like his to keep him out? Okay. They did a really good job. You know what I'm saying? They did a really good job with this game. I gotta give them cookies. There's intake fans there. Interesting. I really like that. Okay, well, we found it. This is what we've been looking for. Well, we want to explore too, and we wanted to get more of the packs and stuff like that, but man, okay, we got it. Thumbs up. You guys, tell me what you're thinking down below. We found it. So we now have the knowledge of where it is, and it's actually super duper 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 close to the packing plant, which I'm ecstatic about. It's ecstatic-ing. No, seriously though, I'm really happy about that. That makes transporting a lot easier, and it would make sense then in the logistics of things to have a base here, at least a farm base type thing. Wrong way. Like maybe like right on the coast here. Is there an island over there? Is that an island or is that just a peninsula? That looks like a peninsula, but that still wouldn't be that bad either. Yeah, we'll have to scout out base places here soon then. And that's the time we've got for today. I hope you guys will like what you see. If you're liking what you see, don't forget to slam the like button. It does help me a lot. Really do appreciate it. And thank you everybody for the support, for sharing, all the good things like that. And look forward to seeing you guys the next Scrap Mechanic Survival episode. And as always, thank you so very much. And you all have a good night. Let's go!